What's up, guys? Thank you again for watching. I know a lot of you have anxiously been waiting to see, and you've been following along on our playlist for Karina's Varus Wide Body Supra. It's been a lot of months, actually, getting all the parts together, piecing everything together nicely, and it's finally ready. So right now we're going to show you everything we did back from the wheels and tires, the spacers, the BBK from the seats and the cage. I mean, for me, it's always nice to see the process and how stuff gets built for everyone's cars and everything like that. But it's just as satisfying to see everything finally come together and see the final result. So without further ado, here it is. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot, tech the style. I flip the script so they can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every road they trace is a scar they keep. Cause when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique. All right, guys, so I figured I'd start out with the most distinctive and unique part of this car, obviously, which is the Varus Supreme A90 wide body is what they call it. This is the second in the US that's been built. If you guys have seen our other videos, we also helped build Daniel Song's Varus wide body, which was the first in the US. Again, this Varus wide body kit's very high quality, made in Japan, very nicely made and handmade carbon fiber. So if you saw in our unboxing video, the kit itself is, I forgot how many pieces there are, but it was a lot of pieces for those guys who've seen the video. But as you saw in the last episode, Cody was able to cut everything needed, and the kit being so high quality didn't need that much massaging to get it to fit correctly and all the lines to get matched up. So, you know, there's very, very nice detailed pieces on the Varus kit. As you can see here in the front, which is very distinctive, this line matches up pretty well. And then this very crucial door piece that matches up with the rear fender, which is a very, you know, much wider look, flows from the door to the rear section of the car. But yeah, a lot of cutting had to happen where Cody had to be very surgical with the tools he was using. You guys can see that in the last episode. One of my favorite pieces is this door cap piece. So, you know, we've installed a bunch of wide body kits here at Studio RSR for Supra specifically. And this Varus kit is the only one that has this nice fitting piece, where other wide body kits have, this is simply just kept open as a slot, and then you just have a giant kind of a divot in here for your gas cap, for your stock gas door. So what I really like about the Varus kit is that they provide a totally different gas door that follows the whole line of the kit, so you don't have that random divot. Also too, with the Varus wide body kit, most of the pieces, if not all the pieces, are full carbon fiber. As you can see in the shot of the diffuser, that's a crazy one by one, very thick weave. And then the other parts are different weaves, but not only is the quality of the carbon fiber evident, they really like to show it off, and it's nice with this white car. You get this tuxedo look, where Karina wanted to do some exposed areas of the carbon fiber to really feature that the kit is actually full authentic carbon fiber. So it's very nice that the quality of Varus's handmade stuff is evident when you look at it, with the weave and the pattern of how everything goes over the different pieces. Some pieces you can't even tell are multiple pieces with multiple layers of carbon fiber, but the weaves match up so well, it looks like one big piece. So you can see this crazy front lip flows really well, starts the whole kit off, and then goes back into the wide body. Luckily, this car's on springs, so, you know, if you were getting this kit, thinking about getting this kit, either be on air or have a nice way to adjust your ride height, because this lip is pretty big.
That's what she said!
Like, I don't know what else to say. Also too, with carbon fiber, I don't know if you guys know how hard it is to make carbon fiber correctly, but the Supra's hood, as most of people know, is actually also part of the fender. So as you can see in the last video where Cody was cutting the carbon fiber, that was actually cutting this crazy design hood. Obviously Varus kept the same design and functionality of the hood. So they made this crazy looking design hood out of carbon fiber with all these crazy shapes and edges. They were still able to maintain that nice clean look for all the carbon. Obviously with a wide body kit, it's not just meant to look good, but when you go wider, you're able to run a much bigger wheel and tire setup,
Yokohama was able to provide their Advan GT Beyonds in racing metallic sand to give this a very unique look and also add that benefit of a square setup. So on the front here, you can see these wider wheels allow us to run 305 tires on these Falcons. To get this wheel and tire fitment, it required custom machined spacers. So you can see here, it's not just really a spacer, it's custom made so that it bolts to the stock wheel hub, just like any other wheel would, but then it also mates with on the other side with another stud kit from Motorsport Hardware. So it's basically like a hub extension or a hub adapter, but just thicker. And then also too, with now this extra grip, Project Mew was able to provide us a big brake kit with their FS6 system. The benefits and features of that are in that other video if you guys have been watching, but real quick, their specific proprietary design on the cooling vanes on the rotor are really what set this off. And then obviously they were able to custom spec this color that Karina wanted to flow with Karina's Holo Holo theme for the car. And to help with that, I don't know if you guys know what Holo Holo means, but if you do, put it in the comments. This next piece should give you a little clue. But obviously we put our 4-point roll cage in the car, and behind these crazy Recaro Pro Racer Hans, you can see the color that she chose for the Holo Holo theme to go with the car. I've been talking with Jarell at Supermark 5 and Karina to see what she thinks about taking the tint off. Comment below if you guys think that we should take the tint off before we take it to SEMA or just leave it as is. It's like a balance, because when you look at the car outside, it's nice to have some tint on it with the black and the white and the tuxedo theme that's going on. But then you don't get to see these really, really crazy Recaro seats and then obviously our cage. When we got these in from Recaro, we had to make sure it was going to fit in the car. We have specific floor adapters that we found works on the Supra, and then also works on a lot of other cars that we use. So we had these ready to go, and it really makes this an even more unique build. And then going around back, we're gonna upgrade these trunk shocks eventually, I believe, right?
Yep.
Okay. So if you guys own a Supra and you happen to have a big wing, we do know of a company or a part number to upgrade these trunk shocks. So that's something we'll do later down the road once we have more time. Opening this up, you can see, this is where you can really see the advantages of the cage and then the matching trunk brace for the Ube part of her Holo Holo theme. All right, guys, we hope you like the build. We've been super stoked to finally show you guys the final result. It's been a few months, actually a lot of months, getting this done. So we've got 1 week left to do the final touches, get the car fully detailed, get it up to Vegas. It'll be in Yokohama's booth at SEMA. Go check it out in person if you can. If not, Instagram is at StudioRSR, and always please like and subscribe. Helps us out a lot here, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.